Oh, hey, 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 hey All right, Gloria.
Still good. Hallelujah.
Bishop. We'd like to have Elder Ray Sherman in the house on the keys for us. I'll give him a round of applause. For those of you who do not know New Life in Christ history, this is our first musician. To defend your home to 307 Bedroom Street. But most importantly, he's been my friend since I was a freshman in high school. It's good to have those types of friendships. I'm going to tell you the good news yet, all right? Mark 6:45-51. If you still looking, say, hold on, preacher. If you still, I was going to say something on the boards, but our computer guy is not in the house today. Our media team, let's call it that. Call it is, call things what they are, amen? Mark 6:45-51. It says, immediately, he made his disciples get into a boat and go ahead of him to the other side, to Bethsaida. And he said goodbye to them and went away to the mountain to pray. Well into the night, the boat was in the middle of the sea, and he was alone on the land. He saw them straining in the oars because the wind was against them. Very early in the morning, he came toward them walking on the sea and wanted to pass by them. When they saw him walking on the sea, they thought it was a ghost and cried out because all they saw, and they were terrified. Immediately he spoke to them and said, have courage. It is me. Don't be afraid. Then he got in the boat with them, and the wind ceased, and they were completely astounded. That's enough. Look at the person next to you. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Say it like you mean it. Neighbor.
Neighbor.
God will.
God will.
Get in it. Say it again. God will get in it.
God will get in it.
With you.
Yes.
Throughout my 36 years of living, I've come to find that the Lord specializes in everything that is good. He specializes in everything that is almost unbelievable. He specializes in miracles, signs, and wonders. Do I have any witnesses in here?
Amen.
They can look through their lives and see that things have happened with no explanation. And without the explanation, you immediately holler, thank you, Jesus, for all that you've done for me. I know I'm not the only one. I remember one time when I was in the military and I was low on funds and all I had was McDonald's money. Seeing a person the 15th, you have steak and potato money. But every day in between then, you have McDonald's money. And I'm just talking about how good God is. We stopped being one of my friends, we stopped at McDonald's, we got us a value meal, you know. Thankfully, we knew some of the people living in McDonald's, so they hooked us up. As I'm sitting at the table eating my, what I would call dinner at the time, there was a lady who complained about her fries and the flies and, you know, this is McDonald's, and come on. And it's one in the hood, so. Y'all know how it is. Flies in her burger, bugs in her juice. So she just had a time of her life trying to figure out. She said, I just gave y'all my last $10 for this. All I had in my pocket was $10. Look at how God works. We bought her the meal. They made her a fresh meal. She ate. She was married.
Yeah.
And on my way back to the military base, something just said, stop and check your account. I told you earlier, I specialize in a God that does things that we can't believe.
Yeah, that's right.
I looked at my account. When I went to McDonald's, all I had was $25. When I went back to look at my account, I had $180. Tell me God was not good. Somebody do today is acknowledge the good things that God has done in your life.
Amen.
And then look at some of the bad things and realize that when you were going through it, God got in it with you. Do I have any witnesses? That is to say, I've struggled with some stuff, but I thank God for getting in the boat with me.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
So when we look at this text, let's talk about this text. Because there's a lot of times where Jesus has his disciples on the sea and they're scared because it's a storm. Let's do some history right here. Let's talk about Bethesda. Bethesda is a little town on the outskirts of the city. Well, you see in the Bible, it says they crossed over the lake of Gennesaret or the Sea of Galilee. Either way, whoever taught you is the same body of water. Yeah. Mm-hmm. When you look at this body of water, you see that it's 7,000 feet below sea level. Wow. In that the water levels are not always right.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
That's just like Hartwell. Y'all seen Hartwell?
Yeah.
You can almost walk down into Hartwell because the water levels are so low.
Uh-huh.
Now, how is it that there's a storm in the place, watch this, that's surrounded by land, not by water.
Uh-huh.
Storms usually groom themselves with water.
Yeah, right.
The water level is low.
Yeah.
How did, where does the storm come from? Somebody tell somebody that God can manufacture whatever he wants to get your attention. God will manufacture whatever he wants to get your attention. Are y'all listening to me? He manufactured this sermon to get your attention. He made the sunrise for those who've been weeping during the night so that your joy would come in the morning. So when we look at this text, we see Jesus says, look, y'all go on ahead and get to the other side. I'm going to the mountain to talk to my Father. Sometimes you got to steal away from who you hang out with. From who you socialize with, from who you frequent the church with, or y'all don't get that exact either. And you gotta pray. And now listen to me, you're not gonna make it in life if you don't pray. God gives you 6 days to do whatever you want.
Yes, right. Come on now, tell it to me.
Okay.
But on the seventh, he said, bring your hind parts here.
Right. Amen. Amen.
When you get here, you recognize him.
Uh-huh.
But what happens when the scene changes? The same things that you recognize him about are still going on.
Right.
He's just in a different place.
Yeah, right.
Okay, because they're not where they're used to seeing him, they're scared now.
Right.
You're not used to seeing them in your home, so you're scared. You're not used to seeing them in your marriage. So a fight turns into, I'm getting ready to leave the house because I'm sick of you.
Come on,
I know what I'm talking about. I know I'm talking, right? It's happening in here. Y'all want to talk to me? It's okay. Because God knows. So they said he walks on the water. Walking on water. Watch this. Remember, when the water level is still low.
Yeah,
right. Says he saw them. Watch this. I thank God. This is what I'm about to say. That I have somebody that when he's going to do what he needs to do, he's still thinking about me. Are y'all listening to me? He went to pray for himself, for his own good. But he was still thinking about me. Watch this. Because not only did he come to the shore, he saw me struggling with what I was struggling with. And said, let me go give him a hand. Now, is there anybody in this room today that's been struggling with your wind and your waves? And you know that you need God. And he stepped in when he stepped in. And not all wind and waves got to be wind and water.
Yeah.
If your money's looking funny,
hey,
that's a storm.
That's right.
If you got more food in the refrigerator, that's a storm.
Hey,
if you got more closet space than you got clothes, that's a storm.
Right.
But thank God that things are well as they are.
Yeah, that's right.
Thank you.
says when they saw him walking by, said they got afraid. But I need somebody to understand that in this season, you better recognize what God is doing.
Yeah.
I realize there's some people out there. You better recognize what God is doing. You better recognize when he's trying to tear down. You better recognize when he's trying to separate. Watch this. You better recognize when he's trying to do a new thing. Y'all ain't with me because I got to his bristle, his rebuttal to them being afraid was, be of good cheer. It's me.
Yeah.
Y'all listen to me?
Yeah.
And I need to tell somebody out there, be of good cheer. It's God.
That's right.
Tell somebody, you better recognize. See, the problem is, we're too busy paying attention to the world, and we've forgotten what Jesus looks like. We forgot what he sounds like. Because we're too caught up in the world.
That's right.
Lord,
mercy.
Right. Amen.
Have good courage. Yes, indeed. That's why I'm not afraid. Right. When things are happening in my life that I can't explain, I know it's God.
Right.
I won't be afraid.
Amen.
When the Bible tells us not to be afraid.
Right.
23rd Psalm, yea, though I walk through the valleys of the shadows of death, I fear no evil. I'm not afraid because you are with me.
Right.
Sound the same, doesn't it? I shouldn't fear anything because it's him. But because I don't recognize him, I'm scared. The problem with the body of Christ is we come to church every Sunday, we wave our hands when the praise and worship is said, wave our hands. But when God begins to move, when he begins to speak, when he begins to do what he does, we don't recognize it anymore.
Preach. Yes, Lord.
Yeah, y'all want to shout this
morning. Preach. Go ahead.
It says that he got in the boat with them. We need to help somebody and tell them that whatever you're going through, something, doesn't matter how big or small, if you call on the name of Jesus, if you call on the name of Jesus, not only will it come to your rescue, he'll get in it with you. And I'm going to show you the benefits of what it's like to have God in it with you. If God doesn't fix the problem for you, this is what I'm about to say. He will fix you for the problem. Some of y'all want God to fix what's going on in your house. Sometimes it's not what's going on in your house. It's how you respond to it. It's not what happens on the job. It's how you respond to it. Are y'all listening to me? It's not what the devil sends your way. It's how you respond to it. That the storm came to distract them.
Yeah.
And you see how they respond with fear.
Yeah.
I don't know about y'all, but I can't respond to anything that's sent to me to destroy my peace with fear.
Yeah, amen. I know that's right.
All right.
You better say that.
No, I'm not listening to
me.
I can't respond with fear.
Yeah.
There's something that's sent to destroy my peace.
Glory.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
I got to be courageous.
Yeah.
Things going to happen.
Yep.
Depression will come.
Yeah.
Sickness will come. Sadness will come.
Yeah.
You know, tragedies happen.
Yeah.
But you got to stay strong.
Yeah.
Y'all listen to me.
Yeah.
You got to have strength.
Yeah.
I used to think of the old preacher about how they used to stutter when they put an eye on. But you need that. Have courage, it's me, do not be afraid. That whole sentence right there. I need somebody to recognize that this week something good is going to happen to you.
Amen.
How many people believe it? Something good is going to happen. But I'm not talking to you. There's some scared folks in the building. I said, how many people believe that something good? Thank you. was getting ready to do. So let's go look at this whole story. Just say, go ahead and read. Because I'm going to pray. I need to pray. We all need to pray. Throughout the Bible, we are admonished to pray. That's how we keep in touch with God. The Bible says in the song of the old church, have a good time with Jesus. Tell them all about your troubles. You hear your famous crying, answer by and by. Won't you do it, somebody? He'll make it all right, won't you? I don't know about y'all, but I know for certain that he'll make it all right. He sent the crowd away. Some of y'all don't even realize that you have spectators and haters. Dictators and all that other stuff. All in one crowd around you. Sometimes you better. For my young people, soldier boy, you.
That's right.
But if you keep the wrong people around you too long, they consume you.
Amen. Glory.
Come on.
Make it plain.
This is how we are in Christ. We like this. We attach together. Y'all follow what I'm saying? Uh-huh. If I have an issue, no matter what he tries to try to run, try to walk away, he ain't going nowhere. I want to tell you why? Because what's on me is now on him. Somebody got my back if I can tell.
Lord.
He saw them straining because the wind was against them. If God be for me.
I know that's right. You better say that.
He's more than the world.
Hey, glory.
Yes. So I'm not worried about who's trying to be the wind in my situation.
Ooh, blow!
I'm not worried about who's trying to be the waves in my situation.
I know that's right. You better say it.
Because one is going to knock me one way, and the other is going to knock me the other. But God is going to bring me out.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, God.
As I close this message, I want everybody in here to know something, that no matter what it is that you're going through, no matter how bad, how rough, how tough your situation may be, that if you need him to, God will get in the midst of it with you.
Woo, glory!
Who else better to have in your circumstances than somebody who's got power over everything?
Yes, Lord!
Who better to have on your side than somebody who defeated death and the grave? I remember when my father would tune up and he would say, I remember when. Come on, brother. I remember when. They took him, and they whooped him all night long.
Yeah. All right, now.
Do I have a witness here?
Yeah.
I remember when they whipped him across his back.
All right, amen.
I remember when they spit on him.
Come on.
I remember when they mocked him.
Yeah.
I remember when they put the cross together. And then carry it up top off of me. And when they got there, they took one spike, put it in one hand, and to another spot. And put it in the oven.
Yes.
Put one more spot between
yes.
the feet. Put a kind of arm over here. And then this can make a sign. Can I tell you, those bruises were for you. They were for you. They were for God. They were for everybody in here. They were for me too. I remember what God did for me. Is it anybody that remembers what the Lord has done for me? If you guide the high, praise God. If you made a way out of the door, praise God. If you need something for me, tell a dying world that the Lord did what he did to me. But let me get back.
Hurt his shoulder. So I'm praying that God give him healing, that he don't need surgery. I'm praying that he get into the college that he wants to get in, and God grant him everything he needs while he's getting there and while he's there. I pray for my son, Chris, for just being a good son. I pray for my mama, because she's still here and she's a great mama. I pray for my grandbaby that needs a little help sometime. And I pray for myself who need help all the time. And I pray for my church family.
Anybody else? Very much family and church family.
Anybody else?
I would ask prayer for my family. I would ask prayer for the church family. I would ask prayer for our youth. Back with
is our cousins. Kyle Calvert, he passed. He was 35 years old, guys, and he had a heart attack. 35. So we want to pray for him. And I also want to pray for the Hunter family. One of my good friends, her mom just got diagnosed with cancer, and they are going through chemo and radiation, and it's just an adjustment for them. So we ask for prayer for them, and also for the self family.
Sunday back, and I pray for them because we've been where they are, and I have classmates and co-workers that are struggling, so I pray for them as they try to heal and get the comfort and everything they need from God.
I give honor to everybody in their respectful place. Praise God for being here. I'm asking the church to pray for my husband, our marriage.
Jesus still saves, and that He loves us. You gave your life that we might live, Lord God. No
in these streets, Lord God, that you will save souls right now, Lord God. And I thank you for it in advance. Lord, I pray for my family, Lord, on behalf of my family, those who don't know you as Savior, Lord. If you don't use me, Lord, use somebody else to tell them about Jesus, Lord. Sometimes we think it's about us, but Lord, sometimes you use other people to win our things, Lord God. And Lord, I thank you for that. Thank you, Lord God, for the person that told me about you years ago. And I came to believe in Jesus. Lord, I thank you, and I just give you the glory, Lord. Heal what we need to be healed, Lord God. And Lord, we thank you, and we will forever give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory that is due unto you. For it's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen, amen.
Amen, amen.